Yeah, I know a lot of us have close connections with the islands. I really began to experience all that they have to offer last summer, and I know that coming back was, oh, I was so excited to get back out here. So, what I would like y'all to look at first is this little map, and this is a map of the different First Nation languages in this area of the Pacific Northwest. The Huasanich people came from what is today called the Vancouver Island, and on the Huasanich Peninsula you can see down kind of near modern day Victoria. There's a very light line. The printer did not do a very good job, and I don't have color printing, but there's a very light line, and that kind of encircling right there is what we consider to be the Samish language group. You'll notice, or you may recognize, some of the languages and people in there, the Lummi people, Semiamu, and of course, the Huasanich. The Huasanich people were, or still are, a people that are very unique and of their own culture, but they are also very similar and share a lot of practices with some of these other people. I read this piece by a man, David Elliott. He is of the Huasanich people, and he compared them and the Lummi people to be brothers, which I think is really cool, because you look at there's a lot of area to cover between where they really settled down. But what is interesting about the Huasanich is they were known as the saltwater people. So they would travel throughout these islands. If you see the upper islands, those are called the Gulf Islands today. And these lower islands are the San Juan Islands. As there are no rivers on the Huasanich Peninsula, and so they would go out into the straits and actually fish for salmon. A lot of these First Nations, the idea of property is very much a colonial idea. But that's not to say that the First Nations did not have kind of regulations and beliefs around how they gathered from this land. The Huasanich people recognized that the salmon that would return to rivers like the Nooksack really belonged to those other people. So they would fish in other areas. They didn't want to take what wasn't theirs, and they recognized that a lot of these people really relied on the salmon to feed their people. By reef netting, which is cool because they would go out into the straits and they would have landmarks on the different islands, and they would drop rocks tied to rope that would sink to the bottom, and at some points this would drop to over 300 feet. And it was said by David Elliott that a lot of the time, or all the time, these rocks would be dropped within mere inches of each other year after year. This area, and over many years of watching and listening and understanding, they came to find patterns within the land, and this, I don't want to call it a calendar, but this representation right here, Nick allowed me to use. He was given it, it was given to him by a woman who goes by Menfie, I believe is how it's pronounced. And these pictures in here signify different times in the year. It's kind of hard to read on the actual picture because of the printing, but I've written out the I guess, so these are all the different moons of the year. And this is the English translation. And so, where do y'all think that we might be right now? Sorry?
Rebirthing.
Okay. So, more so, let's look at, yes, you are right. We're in that. That would be the season. And so let's look at this next, sorry, I didn't explain that very well. That like middle ring. But you are right. We would be in the time considered rebirth of the earth. Mm-hmm. Maybe. Yeah, so the first one, sound of the croaking frog, or sound of the frogs croaking, that would really be the beginning of spring. And they recognized that when the frogs started to croak, the herring would start to come back to this area. As the herring started to come back to the area, they wouldn't take the first group of herring because they didn't want to take the first one. So they would wait until the next waves of herring would start coming in to start gathering and fishing for these species. Moves on. There are different signifiers of different signs that would signify different crops you could harvest or animals that are coming to the area. The bullhead in Shanet, the little bullhead, they would watch for the stars. And as, I'm not sure which constellation it was, but as that constellation moved out of the sky and out of sight, they would know that the bullhead were starting to come back. And the bullhead can't be found there until this time of the year. The Wasanish people were very much tied to the seasons because they were very mobile. They would move throughout the San Juans and throughout the Gulf Islands, gathering and using the land in proper ways. Time, what we consider spring, would be when they would start to move out farther. During this time, they would really spend their time in the Gulf Islands, very close to land. They did not set up permanent residences or permanent housing in these areas. They would make temporary homes, and they would go back and forth between the Saanich Peninsula and the Gulf Islands during a lot of the spring. As the salmon started to come, they would start going out further into the Salish Sea. And this is when they would start to spend longer periods of time out in the islands. That would last from around our June until August. During that time, they would do a lot of fishing as well as harvesting of different crops, such as camas, which we see on this island. They would start to hunt on the Saanich Peninsula, and this is a good time for elk and deer hunting. And so they would just, as the seasons changed, they would really change what they cultivated and what they used, because a lot of the time the population of these animals and plants are a lot healthier at these times. And so they're not taking too much. They were taking just enough. And became more of a winter time. They would start to come back to the Saanich Peninsula. And this is the time when they would spend a lot of time with their people in what was considered the winter ceremonies and the winter dances. I'm not sure what goes on during these ceremonies or these dances, and I don't feel comfortable to tell y'all what went on. And so the Wasanish people did this for thousands of years. It is said, David Elliott, as I've mentioned him earlier, said that his people had been here for hundreds of thousands of years. And they're still here. They didn't ever sell the land or give it up because it was taken from them, unfortunately.